Stephanie, do you want to talk about the S&P and resistance levels and support levels and whether we're likely to have multiple expansion, or do you want to talk about what type of economy we're going to have depending on the makeup of Congress and the executive branch? I guess that might be more in your lane.
Yeah, I mean, I think that there's, I guess, investors at the moment are having to grapple with that difference, which is, you know, how much do I care about fiscal policy and the economy, the macro, versus the kind of sector-specific stuff I might have been worried about under a Biden, a Biden win with Democrats in majority in the Senate, right? So things like tech and healthcare and energy. I think the reality is for investors, there's a little bit of a fine line to trend in the next couple of days as we figure out what the result is. But it's looking more and more likely that we end up in the, what we'd say, like macroeconomically, is the worst outcome, which is a Biden win in the White House, but the Democrats failing to get a majority in the Senate, because we know how opposition politics works, right, in the Senate. And we expect that to be kind of prevail throughout and make the recovery in the U.S. as the coronavirus continues to create problems less strong than it could have been under any of the other scenarios we have got.
So we have talked about gridlock being somewhat friendly, or at least, not something that the markets really frown upon. But when it comes to stimulus, that might be the one area where the cooperation would be welcomed, I guess, by the market. But in general, does that make sense that stock markets don't want anything to happen because of a split government, usually?
So, yeah, in normal times where you're not in the middle of a global pandemic or you're not on the cusp of an economic crisis, then the preference in markets does tend to be investors prefer that governments don't do too much, you know, not too much regulation, not too much legislation, don't change too much. So it allows the kind of pure market factors to drive pricing. The reality is, though, that the macroeconomy is under, you know, extreme pressure because of the pandemic. And I think this is an election where you might jump to a conclusion that this is kind of that kind of no, you know, gridlock is good news. I think would be the wrong conclusion to jump to at this point, for sure.
Right. But given that the markets, at least in the United States, are just barely off all-time highs, even though we haven't had any recent stimulus, I mean, shouldn't your job at this point be all about Jay Powell or the ECB? Isn't that what we're seeing? Doesn't that have a lot to do in zero interest rates and ZERP and everything else?
Yeah, I mean, I think the reality is that sometimes the market moves to, you know, market moves on a given day, particularly around elections, can be a little unpredictable and a little bit maybe counter to the underlying macro story. But as I mentioned, this isn't a pure macro story. I think that's what we're seeing play out. You know, under a Biden split Congress, it's much less likely you get legislation, you know, that's kind of really aggressive towards kind of the traditional energy suppliers. Maybe tech firms are under a little bit less pressure, you know, and healthcare sector too. And all those sectors are really quite a big part of the index, right? So it's hard to kind of parse out how much of this is reflecting the more negative macro environment, or whether that takes a while to get kind of figured out. Because, as you say, there's a hope that there'll be some small stimulus, but the counterfactual is the stimulus would be much bigger, which would have been much more supportive for risk assets. In the meantime, of course, we expect the Fed to continue to be very, very supportive. And I think in this environment, the Fed is more, you know, more constrained and limited to that lower bound because of the absence of fiscal support. The Fed, you know, more weight goes on the Fed to continue to provide that support, right?
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.